God. The second we arrived in New York, we legged it down to Broadway to watch a musical, partly to keep ourselves awake and also, you know, it's Broadway. And oh my God, it was really, really good. Their costumes, their staging, their voices, amazing. Although I do have to say it was kind of stressful to get in because we had short COVID certs, but Mom's internet wasn't working so she couldn't actually pull them up. Thankfully, a really nice guy let me use as a hotspot, so it was sorted in the end. We spent the whole of day two shopping. We went to this mall just outside of the city. It was full of outlets, so everything was at a cheaper price. But we didn't actually buy that much, or as much as I thought we would have. After ice skating, we planned to go to Central Park and then go to the Museum of Natural History and also to the Met. But my brother decided that he was starving and would die without food. So we walked down the whole of Fifth Avenue looking for somewhere to eat, which is full of designer shops, like nowhere to eat. Before we ended up walking all the way back home, which was great. While walking back to the hotel, we found this random shop that was just dedicated to M&Ms. It was really weird, but kind of cool. So we decided to go in and buy some M&Ms, of course. After feeding the brother, we headed back to the hotel room to just have a little bit of a rest, and then we didn't want to waste the day, so we decided to take the free ferry to Staten Island, which goes right past the Statue of Liberty. Really recommend, it's free.
Yeah.
We had quite the agenda this day, but before getting around to any of that, we had to get breakfast at a diner. I'm not sure why, but I've always seen it as this quintessential American experience that I had to do for myself. I don't know if that made sense, but it does for me, and so I kind of had to go to one. So this day in particular, we were planning to meet my uncle Sean, or John as he's known over there. But before doing so, we wanted to visit the Museum of Natural History because obviously we didn't get to go yesterday because my brother decided he was starving and would die without the food. We only got to be there for about 3.5 hours, which isn't nearly enough time because there's so much. Like, I was shocked. There was like 5 stories and so many exhibits. We didn't get to visit all of them or spend as much time in each of them as I would like to. In fact, like the last few exhibits we ran through, it was just a bit of a stressful moment. Other than having to leave quite quickly, it was brilliant. Like, it was just so cool. I definitely recommend, but give yourself longer time to look at stuff. So we dragged Sean, well, we didn't drag Sean. My brother dragged Sean and us all around Queens looking for a pair of Jordans. He was like a little man on a mission, and I swear to God, we went into about 5 shoe shops before we found a pair, and the pair we got were too big for him, but he's happy out with them. We dropped him and the shoes off in the hotel room before bringing Sean back to Grand Central Station to go home. Go on.
Oh, so got some Jordan ones.
Whoa.
And they're so good.
So good?
Yes.
Wow. What's the consensus?
What's that? Hi.
So we were in Grand Central Station saying goodbye to Sean. I was really living my best life, like I felt like I was right out of Gossip Girl.
There's a movie made of that.
Have about 1.5 days left here in New York. I literally do have 1.5 days left in New York, and I am just feeling like sad. Like, I already miss this place and I haven't even left yet, which is kind of worrying. Like, how I feel when I actually leave, it's just a bit frustrating because there's so much more I want to do, but I don't have the time to do it all. I really like the space. I'm definitely gonna come back. Tomorrow I'm hitting up Chinatown, and I think we're gonna go down to Brooklyn. Not sure. Update. Hi, updating. So we started the day off by going to the Edge because we wanted to take some pictures of the skyline and see it like for ourselves, but up from above, because it's much different walking the streets and then seeing it from up high.
Silently pull the strings and watch me come apart for you. I don't believe in that.
If you ever find yourself in Chinatown and are looking for a place to eat, I cannot recommend this place enough. It's called Wohop and it is absolutely sensational. To the US without going to either Target or to Walmart. Like, it's a thing, it's a given. You kind of grow up and you watch all these videos like, ooh, 24-hour challenge in Walmart, and like, it's this big thing. And so naturally we went on a little late night trip to our nearest Target to buy a bunch of American sweets to bring home, which we did devour in like around a week. That's besides the point. Of course, I was in New York, so I had to have some New York pizza. I did have $1 slice pizza, I think, two nights before, but this one was like $3.50, and I'm gonna be honest, I'm not sure where these extra $2 came from, because it didn't taste that much different or that spectacular. I don't know. We only had half a day left in New York, so we wanted to make as much use of the day as possible. So we quickly went back to the diner. It was really handy to get to. It was only like four streets away. We already knew it. So we took a quick breakfast there, and then we wanted to go to the 9/11 memorial and back to Brooklyn to do some vintage shopping. Now you may be thinking, why didn't you go vintage shopping yesterday? Because you crossed the Brooklyn Bridge. Like, it would make sense. I thought it made sense, but my brother and my dad decided that their legs were a bit too tired and that they couldn't walk anymore. So we said, oh, that's fine, you can take the subway back to 42nd Street and then walk the three streets it takes to reach our hotel. They said no, they thought they would get lost, and so we had to push vintage shopping to today and whittle down my five options to one.
Service. Yep.